Now, we continue with unsteady state flow, with steady state flow, sorry, with transient flow. Okay. Transient flow. Now we will have time function. Previously, you do not see any symbol T. Kita nggak ngelihat waktu di sini. Because we have steady state. Yeah. No function of pressure. Because the pressure is constant. Okay. All right. Unsteady state. So for introduction, the pressure disturbance will move away from the wellbore at a rate that is determined by porosity, permeability, fluid equation, fluid viscosity, rock and fluid compressibility. Pressure disturbance radius is continuously increasing with time. So pressure disturbance is like this actually. Yeah, pressure profile or pressure disturbance. So if you look at this picture on the left, we start with static condition. The well is shut in. Flow rate is zero. The pressure is constant everywhere. Yeah, sorry, my poor drawing, my bad drawing. But that's the static condition before production. Now we have here constant flow rate. We produce at constant flow rate, constant Q. Now there will be pressure profile. There will be pressure disturbance like this. So you can see this curve. Picture B is for constant flow rate. Picture C is for constant bottom hole flowing pressure. And the shape, yeah, the shape, the moving way of this pressure disturbance are determined by this parameters. And of course, pressure disturbance radius is increasing with time. So, increasing with time. Semakin lama, radiusnya makin membesar. And the radius is commonly called radius of investigation. Yeah, radius of investigation. As long as the radius of investigation has not reached the reservoir boundary RE, okay, the reservoir will be acting as if it is infinite in size. Jadi sebelum pressure disturbance ini mencapai reservoir boundary, yeah, the reservoir will behave as if it is infinite. Before the pressure disturbance reach the boundary, reservoir boundary, the reservoir will behave as it is infinite in size. Seolah-olah reservoirnya itu berpikir bahwa dia itu infinite, tidak terbatas. Kenapa? Karena pressure disturbance belum berbenturan dengan boundary. Ya, seolah-olah reservoirnya itu ya tidak terbatas, ya samalah istilahnya, analoginya ke kehidupan kita gitu. Kalau seolah-olah tidak ada aturan, ya kita belum punya masalah dalam hidup ini, belum ada batasan-batasan gitu. Kita mengira dunia ini tidak terbatas. Wah, kita kira hidup kita, kebebasan kita, our freedom misalnya, itu tidak terbatas. Tapi ketika kita beranjak dewasa, kita mulai bekerja, kita masuk ke society, kita melihat ternyata banyak batasan di masyarakat ini gitu. Banyak batasan, batasan umur, batasan ekonomi, batasan lokasi, batasan gender, batasan, banyak sekali batasan. Dan barulah kita mengetahui bahwa hidup ini limited. Our freedom is actually limited. Freedom kita tidak terbatas. Ya istilahnya itulah logikanya untuk bisa membahasakan dengan lebih mudah. Reservoir ini behave as if it is infinite. before the pressure disturbance reach the reservoir boundary, the reservoir will think that it is infinite. And during this time, we say that the reservoir is infinite acting because the outer drainage radius, yeah, can be mathematically infinite. Yeah, so again, we have this picture. The transient or unsteady state flow is defined as the time period during which the boundary has no effect on the pressure behavior in the reservoir, and the reservoir will behave as if it's infinite in size. Yeah, so the boundary will have no effect during transient flow. Yeah, the boundary will have no effect during unsteady state flow. Now we start with basic transient flow equation. Okay, if we have inlet flow, we have outlet. For steady state flow, what will happen? For steady state, inlet will be equal to outlet. Yeah, that's why we call this steady state. But for transient flow, it's not. We have inlet, we have outlet, but inlet flow rate will be different from outlet flow rate because something we have here, there will be accumulation. There will be change as a function of time. Now we have long messages here, but bear with me. Yeah? The mathematical formulation of the transient flow equation is based on combining three independent equations and specifying set of boundary and initial conditions that constitute the unsteady state equation. Yeah. Jadi untuk mendevelop basic transient flow equation, we combine three equations. Yeah. So we will combine first continuity equation. We will use also transport equation and compressibility equation to generate transient flow equation. All right? Continuity equation. The continuity equation is essentially a material balance equation that accounts for every pound mass of fluid produced, injected, or remaining in the reservoir. Okay, that's continuity equation, material balance. And then transport equation. The continuity equation is combined with the equation for fluid motion or transport equation to describe the flow rate in and out of the reservoir. Basically, the transport equation is Darcy. So Mr. Darcy is here again. Yeah, Mr. Darcy, Darcy equation in its generalized differential form. Okay, and then the third equation, the compressibility equation. The fluid compressibility equation expressed in terms of density or volume is used in formulating the unsteady state equation with the objective of describing the changes in the fluid volume as a function of pressure. Yeah. So compressibility is very important because the fluid volume will change as a function of pressure. So to generate transient flow equation, we combine continuity equation, transport equation, and compressibility equation. Okay, it's the same case for numerical approach. Yeah. And we also have initial and boundary condition. Okay, it's like calculus. Yeah, we have initial boundary. We have boundary condition, initial condition. There are two boundary conditions and one initial condition required to complete the formulation and the solution of the transient flow equation. So two boundary conditions, yeah, and one initial condition, yeah. So two boundary conditions, one initial condition. The two boundary conditions are the formation produces at the constant rate into the wellbore. Yeah, this is the two boundary conditions. Constant flow rate. The formation produces at constant flow rate into the wellbore. And there is no flow across the outer boundary, and the reservoir behaves as if it were infinite in size. That's two boundary conditions. Now what about initial condition? The initial condition simply states that the reservoir at a uniform pressure when the prediction begins at time zero. Okay, so pressure at time zero at any location PXYZ is uniform, the same, uniform, the same pressure everywhere before production. And now we start to combine all those information. Yeah, the system is the same. We have external pressure, we have bottom flowing pressure, we have reservoir radius, we have reservoir thickness, yeah, wellbore radius, and then we do this balance by focusing on the control volume here. Yeah, we make a slice, kita potong, kita jadikan ini elemen yang kita fokuskan. Now, if you look at this element, we have mass entering volume element during interval delta T. Yeah, the mass coming in is this one, minus mass leaving volume element during interval delta T. So mass coming out is this one. And now we have accumulation, rate of mass accumulation during interval delta T. So it's like this, yeah, in and out, but we will have accumulation there. But this is the balance. This is during interval delta T, yeah. Then, yeah, we go deeper. So if we want to know the mass in, flow rate in, it's delta T multiplied by area where? Area at R plus DR, yeah. Jadi area di sini, di titik ini, itu adalah R plus delta R, plus DR. So area at RDR multiplied by velocity of flowing fluid, multiplied by fluid density at RDR. Okay? So the area of element at the entering side is this one, the area. If you want to know area, is this one. So it's like 2PRH, the same, but now R is R plus DR. So mass in is this one. 2P delta T R plus DR multiplied by reservoir thickness, now multiplied by velocity and density at RDR. That's inlet mass. Now outlet mass. It's like this. So we don't have DR because we now is here. Yeah, so there is no DR, only R here. But if we look at this one, this will be R plus DR. The volume element with a radius of R is given by this one. Yeah, but for DVDR here, the volume element here, so DVDR is 2PRH. So dV, the element volume, is 2 pi RH dr. Yeah, the volume of this element is this one. So this is analytical approach. This is analytical approach. Calculus is important here. And actually, I don't think we will find this in numerical simulation. Yeah. And so to get total mass accumulation during delta T, it's this one. So volume dV multiplied by something about density here. Yeah, dV, density, but there's also porosity there. Okay. So total mass during delta T, this one. Substituting for dV. Yes, now we substitute the dV. dV is this one. We will get this expression. So if we go back to this starting balance, we will have this condition. Yeah, this long expression. Then we process again, divided by 2 pi RH, what will happen? Now we will get this one. This is a very popular equation for petroleum engineering. This is continuity equation. Yeah, this is continuity equation. So if we go back here, if we want to generate transient flow equation, we need to first construct continuity equation. Kita perlu konstruksi continuity equation-nya. And we will get this continuity equation by doing, yeah, mathematical approach, calculus like this. Yeah. By the way, this is the engineering mathematics. Yeah, so if you have lectures about engineering mathematics, this is one of the example of engineering mathematics. Now it's the continuity equation, Anders's law. Continuity equation provides the principle conservation of mass in radial coordinates. The transport equation must be introduced into the continuity equation to relate the fluid velocity to the pressure gradient within the control volume. And now we will combine continuity equation and Darcy's law. Okay? Darcy's law is essentially the basic motion equation, which states that the velocity is proportional to the pressure gradient dPdr. For radial flow, this is the Darcy's law. And this is the Darcy's law. So velocity is something multiplied by permeability, divided by viscosity, multiplied by the pressure gradient, dPdr. Now we will play with engineering mathematics again. So if we combine, yeah, now we will combine the continuity equation, this box, we will combine with Darcy's law. Kita akan menggabungkan Darcy's law dengan continuity equation. So it's the combination between continuity equation and transport equation. We will start with this one. Yeah, so you will find this number again. Yeah, from Darcy's law. Now I want to expand the right hand side. Yeah, so ddt of porosity multiplied by density, so it will be porosity multiplied by d rho dt plus density multiplied by d pore per dt. Now we will recall this one. So go back to our compressibility lecture. Compressibility is 1 per porosity multiplied by d pore dp. Now I will use chain rule. Yeah, chain rule for what? Chain rule for this one. d4 dt is d4 dp multiplied by dp dt. Yeah. We play with calculus again, chain rule. Now substitution. Substitution to what? This one, d4 dt, yeah, d4 dt equals to, yeah, we will play with this one, yeah, rearranging. We will get this one. Okay. And then we will mix, we will combine with these two equations. This is the expansion, and this one is the starting point here. And this one. We will combine and we will get this equation. Yeah, you can do this exercise if you're interested. And then so we will get this combination for transient flow. But it's not the end of the day. The equation is the general partial differential equation used to describe the flow equation of any fluid flowing in a radial direction in porous media. So this is the generalized flow equation. Okay. In addition to this initial assumption, Darcy's equation has been added, which implies that the flow is laminar. So this is laminar or viscous flow. If you have turbulent flow, then there will be modifications necessary to modify this one. Otherwise, the equation is not restricted to any type of fluid and equally valid for gases or liquid. Yeah. So yeah, this equation can be used either gas or liquid, but you need to use this generalized condition. Yeah. Compressible and slightly compressible fluid, however, must be treated separately in order to develop practical equation that can be used to describe the flow behavior of these two fluids. Okay, so we continue with this case, slightly compressible fluid. Yeah, so it's about slightly compressible fluid. Okay, so we start this one. And then if we assume constant permeability and constant viscosity, then it will be like this. Yeah, permeability will go out there. So we will find the permeability here. Also viscosity here. Now I will do expansion. Expansion for this term. So I will have this long term. And then if I do chain rule for this one, then I will get this one. And then I will also use chain rule here. Yeah, continue. We start with this one and then divide by density. So it will be like this one. Now we need to recall that compressibility is 1 per density multiplied by d rho dp. Yeah, multiplied by d rho dp. Now combination, we got this one. Now dpdr, yeah, dpdr actually is considered very small and can be ignored. Yeah, because this is dpdr, but we have squared. dpdr, but it's squared. So it's like 0.01, for example, and then you square. It will be 0.0001. Yeah. If you have 0.1, then if you square, it will be 0.01. So because we have square here, so the gradient will be small, so can be ignored. Yeah, so we can erase this one. Thus, we will have this one. Okay, and then we define total compressibility is C fluid compressibility plus formation compressibility CF. And then after combination, this is one of the most important equation in petroleum engineering. And this is the diffusivity equation. The above equation is called the diffusivity equation. It is one of the most important equations in petroleum engineering. Okay, the equation is particularly used in analysis well testing data, where the time T is commonly recorded in hours. Yeah, so well testing, pressure transient analysis, all of them starting point is diffusivity equation. Okay. Now we will solve the diffusivity equation. Yeah. This is for in days, yeah. In days, it will be like this. But untuk jam, in hours, it will be like this. So, starting from this, if the reservoir contains more than one fluid, then we need to use this total compressibility. But be careful. CT here accounts for the compressibility of any immobile fluid, which may be in the reservoir with the fluid that is flowing. CT here does not imply multiphase flow. Okay, so CT here accounts for the compressibility of any immobile fluid, which may be in the reservoir with the fluid that is flowing. Okay, continue for diffusivity equation. Now we will define this one, this term we will combine. As diffusivity constant. So it will be this term. It will be one per this one. Okay. And you can see this equation shows that pressure is a function of location R and time. Yeah, pressure as a function of radius and time. Jadi tekanan di setiap titik, di setiap waktu akan berubah karena tekanan adalah fungsi dari lokasi atau dari radius R dan fungsi dari waktu T. Oke, kita akan break di 15.30 ya, teman-teman. Oke. Now, still in PDE form. Yeah, this is in partial differential equation form. And we need solution. This equation needs to be solved because we cannot use this for calculation. Yeah. Coba di kalkulator mana kita bisa pakai bentuk seperti ini? Yeah. Kalau kalkulator atau kalau pakai Excel, bentuk seperti ini sangat tidak aplikatif ya, tidak praktikal untuk kita hitung. Kenapa? Karena ada banyak partial differential equation. Ya, akan sangat menyulitkan komputasi. Walaupun sekarang di internet udah banyak ya situs-situs yang bisa menghitungkan kita differential equation, menghitungkan kita partial differential equation. Tinggal masukkan aja bentuknya, udah dapat solusinya. Ya, tapi it's not practical. Because we need to solve this equation. And we need assumption. Homogeneous, isotropic porous medium, so homogeneous. If it is heterogeneous, it will be very, very, very complicated. You can only solve with numerical approach, numerical simulation. And then we also need uniform thickness, single phase flow, laminar flow, rock and fluid properties independent of pressure. Yeah, so actually this is strict assumption. Yeah, start with general equation. If we assume steady state, yeah, if we assume steady state, then dp dt is zero. Karena pressure tidak berubah terhadap waktu. Okay. Dp dt zero. So, if this one is zero, then this will be zero, right-hand side. The above equation is called Laplace equation for steady state flow. Now, we are not talking about steady state flow. We are talking about transient flow here. To obtain a solution to the diffusivity equation, it is necessary to specify an initial condition and impose two boundary condition. Yeah, two boundary condition and one initial condition. Why initial condition? Because here we only have dp dt. Yeah, first order. But why we need two boundary conditions? Because boundary, we are playing with R. Initial condition, we are playing with time. And if you look at the R, it is second order. That's why we need two boundary conditions. So this is the second order. This one is first order. Okay. Now initial condition. The reservoir is at uniform pressure when production begins. This is the initial condition. And these two are two boundary conditions. The first boundary condition is the well is producing at constant production rate. Second boundary condition, reservoir behave as if it is infinite in size. Yeah. Jadi boundary condition pertama adalah Q sama dengan constant. Boundary condition kedua adalah RE is infinite. Now based on the boundary conditions imposed on the diffusivity equation, there are two generalized solution to solve this equation. Yeah, we have constant terminal pressure solution and constant terminal rate solution. The constant terminal pressure solution is designed to provide the cumulative flow at any particular time for a reservoir in which the pressure at one boundary of the reservoir is held constant. This technique is frequently used for water influx calculation in oil and gas reservoir. So this is the case for constant terminal pressure solution. But we also have constant terminal rate solution. For this case, the radial diffusivity equation solve for the pressure change throughout the radial system, providing that the flow rate is held constant at one terminal end of the radial system. And this is more applicable for most condition, yeah? Because we can use terminal rate being constant, yeah, constant terminal rate at producing well. So at producing well, at production well, we can condition the rate will be constant. Kita bisa kondisikan, kita bisa atur flow rate untuk tetap konstan sepanjang waktu. So we can play with the constant terminal rate solution. And these are two commonly used form of the constant terminal solution, constant terminal rate. So we can use exponential integral function, or we can use dimensional pressure PD solution. Yeah. Now we talk about a little bit about constant terminal pressure. In constant rate solution to the radial diffusivity equation, the flow rate is considered to be constant at certain radius. Yeah, usually at wellbore, yeah. And the pressure profile around that radius is determined as a function of time and position. Okay. Now, in constant terminal pressure solution, the pressure is unknown. The pressure is known to be constant at some particular radius, and the solution is designed to provide with the cumulative fluid movement across the specified radius or the boundary. The constant pressure solution is widely used in water influx calculation. So if we have our reservoir here, yeah, it's shaped like cylinder, and then we have aquifer at certain radius RE, and then it is said that the pressure is known to be constant at some particular radius. So the pressure is constant here. Why? Because we have aquifer, water influx. So the pressure is quite constant, for example, PE. Now we can use constant terminal pressure for this case. But if we have reservoir here, and then we have one well, and we produce the well at constant flow rate, then we can use constant terminal rate solution. Now we go to constant terminal rate solution. The constant terminal rate solution is an integral part of most transient test analysis, such as drawdown and pressure build-up analysis. Okay, so for well test analysis, pressure transient analysis, right, we can use constant terminal rate solution. Okay, most of these tests involve producing the well at constant flow rate. Okay, lanjut. Yeah, for well test analysis, most of these tests involve producing the well at constant flow rate, yeah, and recording the flowing pressure as a function of time. That's why we have this one. There are two commonly used form of constant terminal rate solution, yeah. This one already mentioned before, yeah. Exponential integral function solution and dimensionless pressure solution. Now the exponential integral function solution. We need some assumptions. Infinite acting reservoir. So the reservoir is like infinite in size. Reservoirnya besar sekali. Seolah-olah infinite. The well is producing at constant flow rate. The reservoir is at uniform pressure at the start of production, yeah. Uniform pressure, PI. The well with available radius, RW, is centered in a cylindrical reservoir radius, RE. So it's like at the center, yeah, like this picture. No flow across the outer boundary. In this case, we can use this solution. But yeah, it's quite simple, straightforward, except this one we have EI function. Yeah, exponential integral function there. And of course, we cannot use this directly. We cannot use this for Excel in calculator because we still have EI, exponential integral. We need to solve this one. Now we use line source solution. For line source, solution, we can expand this one to be this one. Okay, so exponential integral of minus x. If we expand, then we will have exponential integral like this. And yeah, this is actually like a plot like this. So this is x, this is horizontal axis, it is exponential integral of minus x. And this is the plot version, this is the table version. So if you want to use this equation, you need to look at the table or the plot. It's not actually practical. It's quite complicated, right? So we need to do some approximation. Okay? Let's say x is this one. If you calculate using this formula, usually x is less than 0.01. Yeah. And at this condition, we can simplify this equation to be this equation. Yeah. We can simplify this equation to be this equation, which is very good. So if x is less than 0.01, you can use this one, and the error is very small, 0.25%. Yeah. So if I give you the case, you can use this equation to calculate x. And if x is below 0.01, then you can use this one. Okay, but if I give you x like this, and then x is between 0.01 and 3, and you can use this more complicated form of equation, but it is still doable. Masih bisa lah dipakai approach yang ini, karena ini tetap straightforward. It's quite straightforward, but unfortunately it's long. And the average error is small. It's good, 0.5%. But if after you calculate porosity multiplied by viscosity, total compressibility, R squared, divided by permeability and time, if x is bigger than 10.9, then it should be pointed out that for this x, the exponential integral can be considered zero for all practical reservoir engineering calculation. So it's easy. The EI function will be zero if x greater than 10.9. Okay, so if we use this simplification, yeah, if we use this simplification that I have mentioned, you can solve the equation and you create plot, it will be like this. Yeah, so you see the pressure disturbance will move, will increase as a function of time, right? Like this one, 1 hour, 12 hours, and 24 hours. And we get the same conclusion. The most of the pressure loss occurs close to the wellbore. Near wellbore conditions will exert the greatest influence on flow boundaries, flow behavior. And the pressure profile and drainage radius are continuously changing with time. Now, if we insert the EI function like this one, yeah, starting point from here. Now, if x is less than 0.01, now we can simplify exponential integral to be this one. Then you can use this equation to calculate the case. So if I ask you, make the plot of pressure as a function of radius and time, so you can use this equation. Okay. Now we will set this R to be RW. Why? Because our concern is at the bottom hole pressure. Okay, so we will change this R to be RW. Okay, so we will have this one as the final equation. Yeah, so PR changed to PWF. Bottom hole flowing pressure is initial pressure minus this term, multiplied by logarithmic this one. This is actually porosity, yeah? Like this. So actually you can calculate using your calculator, using Excel, calculate the bottom hull flowing pressure like this. Okay? And we continue if the case is like this. The condition is T is greater than this. Okay? Then we will have this condition, this equation. Okay, and yeah, we still have 12 minutes, yeah. Well, test, now we go to the next solution, the dimensionless pressure drop solution. Previously, it's EI function solution. Now dimensionless pressure drop solution. Well, test analysis often makes use of the concept of dimensionless variable in solving the unsteady state flow equation. The importance of dimensionless variables is that they simplify diffusivity equation and its solution by combining the reservoir parameters such as permeability, porosity, and thereby reduce the total number of unknown. Yeah, so we create dimensionless pressure drop. We start with this one, and then we do rearrangement like this. So we have the dimensionless form on the left and on the right. Okay, now we will play with engineering mathematics with some modifications. Yeah, we will do non-dimensionalization. Yeah, if we call this one dimensionless pressure, and if we call this one as dimensionless RE, so we can simplify this equation to this one. PD equals to logarithmic natural of dimensionless RE. And then we continue. We introduce dimensionless time and dimensionless time with area, TDA. Okay? And this is the term dimensionless pressure, where A is total drainage area, drainage radius and wellbore radius, RE and RW. And then we have RD, dimensionless radius, or we have dimensionless drainage radius. And here we have dimensionless pressure. So we will have non-dimensionalization. So if we play with this diffusivity equation, we do non-dimensionalization, so you can exercise to do this. You will have the non-dimensionalized form of diffusivity equation like this. Jadi kita bentuk utak-atik supaya dia jadi tidak punya dimensi. Now actually this equation is Van Everdingen and Hirsch non-dimensionalized equation. Yeah, this is Van Everdingen and Hirsch equation. This is one of the most popular equation in petroleum engineering. Now assumption, perfectly radial reservoir system. The producing well is in the center and producing at a constant production rate Q. Uniform pressure PI throughout the reservoir before production. No flow across the external radius. So these are the assumption. When a well is put on production at constant flow rate after a shut-in period, the pressure in the wellbore begins to drop and causes a pressure disturbance to spread in the reservoir. We know about that. The influence of the reservoir boundaries or the shape of drainage area does not affect the rate at which the pressure disturbance spreads in the formation. Yes, yeah, no influence from reservoir boundaries or drainage shape. That is why the transient state flow is also called infinite acting state. Yeah, infinite acting state. During the infinite acting period, the declining rate of wellbore pressure and the manner by which the pressure disturbance spreads through the reservoir are determined by the reservoir and fluid characteristics such as porosity, permeability, total compressibility, and viscosity. Ya, jadi penyebaran pressure di seluruh reservoir selama produksi itu dipengaruhi oleh faktor-faktor ini, porosity, permeability, total compressibility, and viscosity. Tidak dipengaruhi oleh boundary maupun bentuk dari drainage shape. Makanya kita bilang infinite acting state. Now we will play again with mathematics. For an infinite acting reservoir, or RED is infinite, the dimensionless pressure drop function is strictly a function of dimensionless time. So PD is a function of TD. And this is the table for PD versus TD. So we have this one, and if we know that dimensionless time is this one, we can look at this table, and we know that for TD lower than 0.01, we can simplify PD to this one. But if it is between 0.02 and 1000, we can use this equation. For TD greater than 100, we can use this equation. Okay. The arrival of pressure disturbance at the well drainage boundary marks the end of transient flow period and the beginning of pseudo steady state period. During this flow state, yeah, during transient flow state, the reservoir boundaries and the shape of drainage area influence the wellbore pressure response, as well as the behavior of the pressure distribution throughout the reservoir. Yeah, during pseudo steady state flow condition. Intuitively, one should not expect the change from transient to semi-steady state in this bounded or finite system to occur instantaneously. There is a short period of time that separates the transition. Yeah, this is a transition time between transient state and pseudo-steady state. And this is called late transient state. Due to its complexity and short duration, the late transient flow is not used in practical well test analysis. Ya, jadi batas antara transient flow and pseudo steady state flow itu ada yang namanya late transient state, tapi itu sangat kompleks dan durasinya itu pendek sekali, jadi seringkali di-exclude dalam analisis. And for finite radial system, the dimensionless pressure function is a function of both the dimensionless time and radius, yeah, because we have finite system. Previously, this is for infinite system, where we have PD only a function of TD. Yeah, so we have PD a function of time and drainage radius. And again, we recall that TD is this, RED is this, both of them non-dimensionless. And then we have this condition for TD greater than 25, 0.25 RED squared, lower than TD, we can use this equation. For RED squared greater than 1, we can use this equation. And we do this computational procedure using PD function to determine bottom hole flowing pressure. Changing the transient period is like this. So step one, we calculate dimensionless time, this one, and then calculate dimensionless radius using this one, RE divided by RW. And then using the calculated values of TD and RED, we determine the corresponding pressure function, PD, from the appropriate table or equation. Yeah, so we can use either this one, or either this one, or we can also use the table. Yeah. And we will solve the pressure at desired radius by using this equation. Now some comment: the dimensionless pressure drop solution and EI function solution. The solution as given by dimensionless pressure function technique is actually identical to exponential integral function. The main difference between the two formulations is that PD function can be only used to calculate pressure at radius R when the flow rate Q is constant and known. In that case, the PD function application is essentially restricted to the wellbore radius because the rate is usually known. Ya, jadi PD function usually it is restricted ya, susah dipakai kecuali kasus di mana di wellbore radius karena kita tahu flow rate-nya dan kita bisa jaga flow rate-nya constant. On the other hand, the EI function approach can be used to calculate the pressure at any radius in the reservoir by using the well flow rate Q. And then it should be pointed out that for an infinite acting reservoir with TD greater than zero, the PD function is related to this one.